Hello everyone, and welcome to another Let's Play of Long Live the Queen by Hanako Games. My name is Anna Martel, and today we will be doing the Evil Elodie walkthrough, but caveat, there's actually two Evil Elodies. There's one where she's like evil and queen and sort of master of her domain, and there's one where she's evil and not queen and gives up her throne to basically go become a minion. There's a what is the word I'm looking for? There's an achievement for that called to serve evil, and so I'm going to show you how to get that. So with that having been said, I want to apologize. I'm going to take a minute to say I'm sorry that I have not updated this Let's Play sooner. This is actually a really hard game in terms of remembering which week needs which stats in order to survive and how to get those stats and still work for the ending that you want. It's a lot of stuff to keep juggling at the same time. I was really intensely into the game for a few months and knew like everything, and then I stopped and all the knowledge just sort of drained away, and it was really hard to pick back up. So, and I still haven't, by the way. I'm using a walkthrough that I found on the Steam forums by a user named Trial by Dark Fire. I will be linking to it in the video description because I want them to get all the credit for figuring out this walkthrough. Also, as a lot of you know, the game had a very major update after most of my videos, and the update basically broke all the online walkthroughs that had already existed, which makes it really harder, even more so, to try to get the ending that you want. So I'm still gonna try to do the endings. It kind of depends on me finding a walkthrough that works for me. And so today we're going to do the walkthrough of To Serve Evil, where Elodie becomes a minion. So we're going to dive into this. By the way, this is going to be a long one. I get a whole bunch of comments on the Long Live the Queen playthroughs saying that I talk too much and they're too long. And I'm like, I'm sorry, because I don't know how to make them any shorter. It's a long game, and don't know that it really should be broken up. Maybe it should, I don't know. But I'm not doing that, at least not yet. So, let's get into this. A couple more technical details. I always yammer on so much at the beginning, I'm sorry. I finally invested in a Blue Yeti microphone because all my other microphones basically broke. And so I had to buy a new one, and I thought, well, I guess I'll get the one that all the professionals use. So far it seems really good. Let me know how it's going. And today I'm using Lightcam because I was using Fraps before and it didn't recognize Long Live the Queen. So let me know on your end if you can hear me all right, because I'm always trying to tweak the settings to work. So, okay, having said that, let's start this game. And then let's immediately pause because I don't want the skip ahead. I had to, hide skip button. I had to, go through this once to make sure it actually worked, because I didn't know if the walkthrough applied before the update or after. Okay. So this is Joslin, King Dowager, Duke of Caloris. He is your father. He's not useful. That's usually how I introduce him. But he can't be. We're a 14-year-old queen. We're supposed to be figuring things out on our own. So he says, we're almost home. Your room is just the way you left it. This is Elodie, this is us. Our job is to keep her alive until the end of the game. And that's like 36 weeks of mayhem. I know it's hard to leave your school and all your friends, but I've arranged the best possible tutors for every subject. You'll have to work hard this year to prepare yourself before your 15th birthday, but I know you can do it. You'll learn quickly, and you'll make a wonderful queen. It's what your mother would have wanted. This is not what mother would have wanted. She wouldn't have wanted to die and leave me. No, she wouldn't. But sometimes bad things happen. We have to pick up and carry on. All of Nova depends on us. On you. Sigh. All right. Let us do this. We've played this before. So here's our mood. We're very depressed. And here's our skills. We know nothing right now. So for week one, we're going to do economics and accounting, and we're going to do more economics and accounting. We're going to do two accountings. And the reason we're doing accounting early is so we can unlock lumen powers as early as we absolutely can. So you brush up on basic mathematics, and you study the manipulation of larger quantities through direct calculations. What's all that noise outside? Who's there? Oh, it's my cousins! So this is Lucille, Countess of Nyx. And this is Laurent, Duke of Merva. And this is Charlotte. Hi, Lottie. I haven't seen you in ages. Maybe we'll have some time to talk later. So we're going to go visit Charlotte and Lady Merva. You should visit more often. It's awful that the only time I get to see you is when something like this happens. At least we can have fun here together. I'm not going to read all this stuff. I assume if you're watching these, you've probably seen this game about 9 times now. So for week 2, we're going to do some more accounting classes and we're going to do trade. Because if you remember, we can't just beef up on one of these 3 subsets of economics in order to get past 50. You have to have a baseline of 25 in all 3, which is to prevent someone from basically ignoring entirely one aspect of a subject. So here's our accounting. And here is our trade. You learn that even the smallest of villages has a central market where locals can trade what they have grown or made with others who have different skills. What was the first one? You study money lending and the controversies involved in charging interest. According to the Druids, one should always return more than is loaned or else the debt gave no value to the world. That's an interesting bit of world building. I like that. What's that commotion outside? What's going on? This is Juliana, Duchess of Ursul. I have come to pay my respects in honor of your mother. Jocelyn, our father, does not like Juliana. I have complicated feelings about her, which you can find in the other videos of this playlist. So, our options are to send her away, arrest her, or let her stay. I'm going to arrest her. Someone asked, why do you always arrest her? And partly I arrest her because right here we're getting mood bonuses. So now we're going to visit her in the dungeons to get her immediately back out. The Duchess of Ursul is there in her cell, sitting perfectly straight on the bench against the wall and looking your direction as if she'd been expecting you. Caution is wise for one in your position. Hasty judgments can lead to trouble. Are you ready to listen now? So we're going to hear her out. What do you want to say? It is the responsibility of the king or queen of Nova to handle magic energies to protect the domain. That is what a lumen does, what your mother did, and what I do. My father said it was your fault she died. What he said was that she died by magic. Being a lumen is never safe. We pay a high price for our powers. But without a lumen queen, this entire domain is at risk. Release me and I will teach you what you need to know to keep your responsibilities. So we're gonna free her. I don't have any choice, do I? Fine, I'll have the guards release you. Come to me in your room, in my rooms, as soon as you can begin your... Let's try that again. We can't. The scroll wheel won't take me back. Well, you probably saw it. Basically, she said to come visit her when you're ready to start the training. All right. Week 3. Here it is. Week 3 up here. Wish that was a little bit bigger. So our classes, we're going to take trade and trade. And if you look at our skills, here we are with economics. We need to get trade up and then production up, and then we can continue doing accounting. Or in whatever order, really. But basically, these 3 have to be at 25 before we can boost this over 50. So, and our current mood is depressed. And I don't know that this walkthrough was optimized for mood. I actually need to go back and try to tweak it to see if we can get the other evil Elodie ending. But man, it's a lot of math to try to work out. All right, let's do our classes. Trade and trade. You learn that individual peddlers travel between villages and cities, some on foot with packs and mules, other riding horses or wagons. Sometimes different wagons group together to form a caravan. The most important trade route in the domain is the Kavala River. It travels through the center of your lands, and almost every duchy contains tributaries that feed into the Kavala, allowing goods to be shipped along it by boat. So here we are playing with Charlotte in the gardens. All of a sudden, the Duchess of Azul rushes into the garden and points a sword at you. No, not at you. At your feet? Princess, don't move. So we're going to look down. You look down where the sword is pointing. There's a snake in the grass. You can't help it. You squeak and jump back. The snake tenses and prepares to strike. Your cousin pushes you aside, and the snake's fangs sink into her leg. Too late, Juliana swings her sword and cuts off the snake's head. What is going on out here? Your daughter's been bitten by a milk viper. They're poisonous. Get an herbalist right away. I will treat my daughter. I certainly can't trust anyone here to keep her safe. I don't feel good. Your aunt has a point. Milk vipers are not native to this area. That snake should never have been here. Someone may have tried to kill you. So, spoilers, it was totally the black-haired woman who was Charlotte's mom trying to kill us. So, now we're going to go talk to Juliana. What is it you wanted to teach me? First, I need to know if you have your mother's crystal. What crystal? The source of power for any lumen is a particular magic crystal. Once you've bonded with it, it becomes a part of you as long as you live. The royal crystal has been passed down from ruler to ruler for generations. It belongs to you now, except that the king may be keeping it from you. Do you have a crystal? Of course. She holds out her hands. Light flickers above her bosom, and then with a shower of sparkles, something takes shape. You reach out to touch it, and it dissolves away into nothing. Oh, it belongs to me. No one can take it from me until I die. You need to find the crystal that belongs to you. All right, week 4. We're going to take production. Trying to get to a point where we can up our accounting. You learn that the Sunset Bay off the coast of Duchy Mazumba is a prime location for fishing. You learn how farmers in the Duchess of Mari rotate between fields for raising crops and fields that lie fallow. And we unlocked a new outfit because we hit 25 on all three of the economics subsets. Her mother says Charlotte's doing okay, so I guess it turned out all right. All right, we're gonna go talk to our father now. Dad, what happened to Mom's lumen crystal? It's in a safe place. Can I have it? No. But it's mine. Meddling with magic killed your mother. I don't want that to happen to you. Once you're crowned queen, I can't stop you from doing anything you want. But for now, you are still a child. Okay, now we're gonna put on the new outfit we just unlocked. Tuxedo. That boosts our economics. Classes. 2 counts of accounting. You study bookkeeping and the art of notating incomes and expenditures, as well as how to determine the amount of funds a solvent business needs to keep on hand in order to continue functioning. You learn about the concept of diminishing returns, a point after which spending more on a particular project fails to improve it as much as previous spending did. You study taxation and learn about how past monarchs demanded too much and drove peasants into ruin in order to collect it. Other monarchs demanded too little and drove whole domains into ruins by lacking the funds to sustain and defend them. One of the maids approaches for your attention. My lady, couriers have arrived from the Duke of Sedna. We have a Duke of Sedna? No,
My lady, the Duke of Sedna is in Talais. They have brought you a letter and a gift.
Oh, what a beautiful necklace! Something sparkly will make me feel better.
All right, now we're going to visit our treasury and get our crystal.
You overwhelm the guards with facts and figures, explaining that you need treasury access to adjust the royal budget, which may affect their pay packets as well as the taxes assessed on their friends and family. They stand aside.
The glitter is dazzling, but some sixth sense draws you towards one little locked box in particular. This is what you need. This is the crystal that will make you a lumen. You tuck the box into your pocket. You can show it to your mentor later and get instructions on what to do next. Okay. In the walkthrough that we're following, we next did dance classes. And I do not think that it actually ever affected anything. So here is where potentially, there we are. Bonus to agility. Oh, well, okay, so we get a bonus to agility, which is dance. Potentially, if we were trying to tweak the walkthrough, this is maybe a place where we could get some savings. But I need to check. So anyway, following the walkthrough that I know works, here is where we dance. You practice curtsying, standing, and walking across the floor in a graceful manner. We're getting an afraid bonus. Now you notice that when we were doing economics for all the weeks up to now, we were not getting an emotion bonus. And theoretically, that's another place where we could tighten up the walkthrough, because emotion bonuses help so much. Without the bonus, we'd get 10 instead of 15. So the emotion bonus is huge if you can get it, but that's part of what makes the game so hard to min-max, because handling all the emotions is... This is a hard game, guys! You practice walking on the arm of a partner and following their cues to pause and turn while keeping your eyes closed. You practice different partner dance positions, closely held, at a distance, and non-contact, and the appropriate hand placement for each. As you are walking, you spot a familiar figure in the palace gardens.
It's the Duchess of Ursule. Maybe I should go and say hello.
Then you notice that seated beside her is a woman in the robes of a priestess. They are very close together, their hands gently touching as they speak.
Looks like she's busy.
You turn and walk in a different direction so as not to disturb them. At that moment, you notice something unusual. It looks like someone just left the palace grounds by going over the hedge. Was that a servant, a thief, or an assassin? So we're gonna call the guards.
Guards!
I got an angry bonus. By the time the response is organized and directed to the area beyond the palace, there's no sign of any intruder.
Let us go talk to Juliana.
I got it! What do I do now?
Pick up the crystal with your bare hands. Press it against your chest, over your heart, and say, illuminate.
Okay, here we go. Illuminate!
And here, now we are a magical girl. You feel dizzy and both larger and lighter than you were before. The crystal has disappeared from view, but you know where it is. The priestess here is a friend of mine. I will come to your lessons in the faith and train you to use your powers. All right, now we are going to do lumen training, and it's going to be for a while. And let me see, we're currently at a bonus to lumen, which is good. Off we go, sense magic. You close your eyes and learn to feel the magic inside you. You practice using small amounts of magic and feeling that power outside of yourself. Your mentor summons up magical energies to strike the nearby ground, so you can learn to sense someone else's spells in use. As you are walking up the stairs, a maid comes running down holding a towering pile of linen. Before you can react, she barrels into you, sending you and the sheets flying.
Oh, my lady, I'm so sorry!
So we're going to punish her, because that's part of getting our cruelty up, which is necessary for the ending.
How dare you! What do you think you're doing? I'll have you flogged for this. Yes, my lady. Let's visit the treasury to stay willful. You visit the royal treasury and check your available funds. Alright, for week 8, we are going to do resist magic. You increase your awareness of your own thoughts and emotions, making it more difficult for mind-affecting magic to twist your reactions. You learn to consciously project a magical field through your thoughts, blocking outside magic from touching your mind, but only when you have the energy to consciously resist. You gain innate resistance to light and dark. You can now see in the blackest caves or stare into the sun without going blind. Nice. There is a man here to see you. He wishes crown funding for a project of his. Your Highness, I have a plan to print books using metal letters which can be moved and reused. So, we needed projection and trade. If it really works, that could be an important invention, so we're going to invest. We would be happy to invest in your venture. And we're going to check our funds again. For week 9, we're going to wield magic. And again, we're trying to get these all up past... Well, we're not even trying to get them all up past 25. We're trying to max them all out. But in order to do that, we do have to get them all past 25 first. So. You learn to summon a small glowing light, which you can then move around independently. You learn how to cast rays of white light, which can banish shadows and blind your opponents. You learn to create tiny discs of solid light, which can fly through the air and cut into targets. You have unlocked a new outfit. This is Banyan, Duke of Marie. Your Highness, my sympathies for your loss. Even after all these years, I sometimes forget that my own mother will never be coming back. Thank you. However, I must call for your aid. The Ixionite occupation of the country of Ibrium has gone on for too long. Now is the time to push back. I know there's been some problems with Ixion, but I don't know the details. I guess they're occupying Southern Marie. I don't know anything about the military. I don't want to fight. There must be a peaceful way to settle this. I will send for diplomats from Ixion and try to come to some arrangement. Thank you, Your Highness. Your Highness, if I may ask, that necklace you're wearing, where did it come from? It was a gift from the Duke of Sedna. Then you have made arrangements with him? What sort of arrangements? Your Highness, that is a courting gift. The man wishes to gain your hand in marriage. Oh, I didn't realize. Whoops. So after wielding magic this week, we're going to attend court. Sitting in on court sessions is not fun at all, but it pleases your father. Okay. We're on week 10, and I'm going to save just in case. I don't know. I'm calling this E for evil Elodie. Did it take? I thought we were on week 10, but that says week 9. We are in week 10. I guess we're going into week 10. I don't know. Anyway, magical girl, Boost Lumen, new outfit. Here's our skills, which the green is the extra boost that the outfit gives us. And here's our mood, which is currently willful. And we are going to go back to sensing magic. Because now we can pass that 50 threshold. And that outfit is so ridiculous. I'm sorry. You close your eyes and call out when you detect your mentor casting a silent spell beside you. You learn to detect ongoing enchantments, such as blessed weapons, that can do magical damage. You learn to tell the difference between different kinds of magical signatures, so that you can tell roughly what a spell you detect is meant to achieve. You expand your magical perceptions to give you some idea of where a detected spell was cast from and how long ago. The representative from Ixion is here. Be careful. No one wants to give up prizes that they have won. You have the full support of my sister and myself. Let's just get this over with. Your Royal Highness, thank you for granting me this audience. I'm sure we can come to an amicable arrangement.
We can be good neighbors again without any lives being lost. So again, we're trying to up our cruelty, so we're going to execute him.
And here you have our answer. Off with his head! Ship that back to Ixion. If they know what's good for them, they'll get out of my way.
So we're going to attend service to bring down the angry we just got, because we want to stay willful. So here are our skills. Here's our mood. We're still willful. Outfit is the magic girl. And we're going to... And this is where I'm kind of... The walkthrough says to take 2 more sense magics. Which will... Without the outfit... 2 more sense magics at this point would be 15 and another 15, so it would be a 30. So it would legitimately bring this to 100. With the outfit, we don't actually need a full... the first class will take us to 80 plus 15 is 95. Plus, there's going to be a bonus for having done so much of the others. So I almost want to do just one sense magic and save the class. But I'm following the walkthrough. But here is another place that maybe we could save a week and do something else. Like I said, I need to math at it. But we will follow the walkthrough. We're going to do 2 sense magics.
You learn to detect the latent power that signifies a lumen, even when he or she is not actively working magic. So this 93 is without the outfit. So with the outfit, we're definitely at 100, even without taking the second sense magic class. You expand your senses, learning to detect spells and magical creatures at a greater distance. You learn to detect lingering traces of strong magic from the past, even when the spell has long since completed. You receive a report on the outcome of the battle against the Ixionites. You succeeded in driving them out of Marie, but it cost you almost a full battalion of soldiers and a great deal of material. You lost 1,000 soldiers. The Duke of Marie will be happy, but we could have done better. You also receive a letter informing you that Talaris, Duke of Sedna, will be arriving for an official visit next week. So we're going to talk to Juliana.
Psst. I need to talk to you.
What is it?
That priestess, Celine. She's a lumen. I can sense it.
Okay, so I wonder if this conversation requires you to have 100 sense magic without the outfit. That would explain the need to max it all the way out. I don't know. I'd have to check.
I know. What do you mean, you know? If you knew that, why didn't you tell me?
You didn't need to know. Your job is managing the domain. Some of us have other duties. Our missions have been passed down for centuries, little princess. We are here to train you. You don't need to know any more than that. You're supposed to obey me. I order you to tell me everything you know. That would require more time than we have available. If you survive, you will learn.
Gah! I don't actually like Juliana very much, so... And I know lots of people do, and that's fine, too. I do not like how much information she withholds from Elodie, because I think a lot of it is actually pretty important. But, but it's okay. So for week 12, we are going to move to resist magic.
You learn to consciously project a magical shield around your body, blocking intrusion. A powerful technique, but you can't keep it up for long. You gain increased resistance against heat and cold, becoming comfortable in different weather and environments, and able to sip hot soup without burning your tongue. You learn how to quickly flare magical shields around you to deflect an incoming attack. This uses much less energy than a constant shield, but it requires good timing to be effective. You learn how to maintain a low-level deflection field, so that magical attacks not directly targeted at you will slide harmlessly aside. This doesn't need much power, so you can keep it up for long periods of time.
Ah, Your Highness, what a pleasure it is to meet you in person at last. Your description did not do you justice.
Giggle. I don't know how to deal with handsome older men paying me compliments.
So we can accept his father or decline. We're going to decline.
I need to let him down gently. I am not marrying you. I'm only 14.
That may not have been gentle.
I see. I regret the misunderstanding.
So we're going to go talk to father.
Dad, if this trouble with Ixion started years ago, why didn't Mom fix it?
Your mother told the Duke of Marie and the Duchess of Hellas that it was their problem and they should sort it out themselves.
Oh, should I have done that?
The situation is different now. Everyone on all sides wishes to see what sort of queen is coming to the throne.
Everyone is judging me.
So, here are our skills. We're going to, according to the walkthrough, we're going to do two resist magics here. Again, potentially we could do one resist magic, leave the outfit on, and still be at 100 effectively. So, again, this is a place where I'm looking at the walkthrough thinking, maybe we could change this slightly. You know, I don't know. You learn how to directly counter offensive magic with your own power so that you can cast Burnout. So that you can burn out a spell that someone else has cast. This is very dangerous if the other spell is too powerful. Your increased skill and power gives you innate resistance to mind-affecting magic. Your understanding of the flow of power gives you increased resistance to damage caused by magic, even without a shield. You can still be hurt, but less than an ordinary human would be. You are required to stand in judgment. A woman has been convicted of attempted murder and requests the mercy of the crown. So we've seen this one before. And because we're going to up our cruelty, we're going to execute her. As she is clearly guilty, her life is forfeit. She will be hanged in public as a deterrent to other criminals. Your personal guards step into action, cutting the woman down before she can endanger you. Get that out of here. Put it on display so that everyone sees what happens to criminals. We're going to attend court. And now we're going to move from resist magic to wielding magic. By concentrating, you can create a wave of discontent, which panics or enrages animals in the area. You learn to create a blade of solid light, which you can wield like a sword to slice through flesh and stone alike. You learn to direct a beam of searing light through the end of a staff, burning whatever you point at. By concentrating, you can create a wave of discontent which panics, confuses, or enrages other people around you. You learn to shape light into images of things that are far away or things that don't exist at all. So we failed a divination test, and we don't know what a keythong is. And we are going to go to court. All right, so here are our skills. We're gonna do one more wield magic. And we are going to move to intrigue foreign intelligence now. You learn to create a powerful explosion of light, burning those caught within and blinding others who look at it. You learn how to make use of images to wield your other powers at great distance. The current Duke of Sedna is 26 years old and unmarried. He might be a good marriage prospect for you if you desire stronger ties with the domain of Talaise. Remember that the festival of the Good Lady is approaching. There will be public celebrations for the commoners, followed by a grand gala for the nobility. I wonder if that was added, because way back at the beginning, whenever there was dancing, I was like,
How was I supposed to know about this? So I don't know if this was added, but it would be cool if it did. As queen, you would be expected to lead the procession and take part in the ceremonial planting, possibly give a speech. However, since you are not crowned, it is not required. Word has come from the factory for books that you funded. They have assembled enough equipment to begin printing test pamphlets. As their royal sponsor, it is your right to decide the content of the first printing. So, we could do pro-Lumen propaganda, which I think is important for the good Lumen ending, but the walkthrough says to do religious doctrine, so we're going to do that. We should take this opportunity to celebrate our devotion to the gods, especially the good lady. The temples will be pleased by your piety. All right. Now we're going to attend court. Our mood is... yielding. Because that's got full... Our mood is out there. That's going to be hard to bring everything back down. Anyway, yielding. And we are... that gives a bonus to history and faith. Which is strange, I would have thought. I mean, we're about to do a whole bunch of intrigue. I would have thought that we would try to emotionally... prep for that. How odd. We're gonna do foreign intelligence and more foreign intelligence. I don't understand why the mood isn't being optimized for this. The domain of Shangjia, across the sea to the west, has been steadily increasing in size, and now controls a wide range of coastline, as well as most of the navigable rivers. The political disruption in Tombula in recent years has caused a disruption in their chocolate production, which is to the benefit of Noba, particularly the Duchy of Kigal. Today is the procession and planting of the Festival of the Good Lady, so we have to decide whether to go, and we're going to say no, I'm not going to go. Suddenly you hear someone moving around inside your room. You turn in surprise, but it's only a maid. My lady, what, should you not be in the procession? Skipping a major festival. Is everyone wondering about me? So we're going to yell at her. Poor Lalas. It's none of your business. Why are you in here anyway? Were you trying to steal something from my room? Get out. So we're going to visit the treasury. We are now angry, which gives a bonus to weapons and military, but not a bonus to intrigue. So I'm still a little confused about that. For week 17, we're going to do ciphering. You practice reading words whose letters have been arranged in reverse order. The simple of transpositions, which anyone literate can puzzle through if they try, but sometimes useful to hide information. You practice shifting substitution ciphers, where each letter is replaced by one a few steps further along the alphabet. I'm not good at ciphering. All right, now we're going to have the gala. And we fail all the tests. After this, you must choose your own partner. There are a number of men who hope to catch your eye. So we're going to pick someone scandalous. You don't want everyone assuming that whoever you pick first is your intended marriage partner. With that in mind, you approach the Duchess of Ursul. You admit to yourself that you were hoping such an outrageous act would cause her to lose some of her composure, but she remains unruffled. At least the chorus of shocked whispers around you as you take your place on the floor is gratifying. And now we're going to dance badly. If I might have your attention, I believe we should offer our compliments to our lovely hostess. Her bravery and courage keep our borders defended. So, Banyan is not angry at us because we got back his piece of his duchy without making his sister get married or any concessions at all. Strange that there's no sign of your cousins. Your aunt and uncle are here. It would be scandalous if they hadn't come. There's something itching at your senses, something familiar. Then it hits you. Aunt Lucille is a lumen.
So we're going to go talk to our aunt.
Aunt Lucille, may I speak with you privately?
Of course, dear. You withdraw to a small side room. I can sense your powers. You're a lumen.
What? I am too. That's how I know. Can't you sense that?
No. No, I can't. She looks down, shaking her head.
I do have a lumen crystal. I found it years ago. It called to me, but I don't know anything about magic. I can make the crystal appear and disappear, and I can block out sound with it. That's all.
I don't think that's true at all. There are traces of old magic around her, too faint to make sense of, but strong.
Why keep it hidden? It's not illegal to be a lumen.
Magic is dangerous. Everyone knows that. People might think I was an evil witch. They wouldn't trust me. Look at how much trouble the Duchess of Rasul has. Please, Your Highness, don't tell anyone.
So we're going to accuse her.
I don't think you're weak at all. I think there's something else you're hiding.
Like what?
You open your mouth to answer her and find yourself unable to speak or move.
My power isn't like your power, little princess. I control the absence of things. Sound, light, life. But you dying now would be too suspicious. Instead, you're going to have a very unfortunate accident. You will remain alive and helpless until everyone gives up hope of your recovery, and then you will die. That's what you think. Calling on your core of inner strength, you push your own magical energy into her spell, overloading it.
What? What are you doing?
There is a loud noise and the smell of burning. When you can move again, you find your aunt lying lifeless on the ground, a glimmering purple crystal beside her. Moments later, your father rushes into the room.
Elodie, what happened?
Aunt Lucille was an evil lumen. She attacked me.
It's all right. She's gone now.
You feel drained of all energy and can barely keep your eyes open. Leaving your father to clean up the mess, you crawl off to bed.
Okay, so we're going to have to take some of the depression off. What is our mood now? Pressured. Athletics and faith. Alright, for our classes, we are going to learn internal affairs and more ciphering.
Until you have children of your own, your maternal uncle, the Duke of Merva, is next in line for the crown, and after him would be his daughter, your cousin Charlotte. You practice random substitution ciphers, where the normal alphabet is replaced by one in jumbled order. This is harder to decode, but most people need a written substitution chart to read or write it, and that chart can be lost or stolen. You wander downstairs to visit your father, and he has a companion. So we're going to insult her.
Good afternoon, Countess. My, what large breasts you have. Putting them on display for any particular reason?
Don't give me that look, young lady. She's a nice woman, nothing more. You should be careful how you deal with people like Siren. You need the goodwill of your nobles as well as your commoners. As queen, you must be aware of everything around you.
So we're going to say to check on noble plots.
I need to know what the other nobles are up to and whether anyone is plotting behind my back.
All of a sudden, there is a scream from the hallway. Rushing outside, you find a young squire lying on the floor. An amorphous black shape, like the imprint of a monstrous hand, surrounds his neck. He is not moving. Before your eyes, the darkness fades away, leaving only ordinary bruises and a body. It doesn't feel like a spell. Not a lumen spell, anyway.
So, this is one of those things where if Juliana told us things, because I can't remember for sure, it's been a little while, but I think that's backlash from the magical battle that we had with our aunt. And knowing that there's backlash like that would have been good to know so we could tell Juliana earlier and she could stop this before it happened, but we didn't know to tell her after the party. Anyway,
I'm scared.
What has happened?
First, my aunt turned out to be a lumen and attacked me, and now a mysterious darkness is killing people.
Your aunt, tell me everything.
You explained the encounter with the Countess of Nyx at the gala, how she tried to ensorcel you, and you drove back her magic with your own, killing her in the process. Then you described the living shadow which strangled a squire and vanished before your eyes.
A creeping shade. I'll take care of it. Don't worry. No one else will die.
Wait! What's a creeping shade? Why is it here? What am I supposed to do about it?
It is your responsibility to study and become a queen. It is my responsibility to deal with dangers like this. You are distracting yourself and me. You are wasting my time and putting others at risk.
Ugh!
Go, do what you do. I will do what I do.
I don't agree with Juliana. I know that not everybody shares my opinion, but there we are. Okay. It's okay not to share my opinion. I'm not gonna be mad. We're gonna up our internal intelligence. Internal affairs, sorry.
Your maternal uncle's wife, the Countess Nyx, claims kinship to the old Merva line and originally asked your mother for the title to the duchy. However, no one could verify her lineage. As a compromise, your mother created her brother, Duke of Merva. The last Duke of Mead was the older half-brother of the current Duchess. His reign was brief and highly scandalous. He defied tradition to pledge himself as the life mate of the old Duke of Ursul, then broke that off only a year later. He retired into seclusion and died still unwed. The Duke of Mari, that's Banyan, has paid suit to the Duchess of Ursul, that's Juliana, to no avail. The Duchess's brother is opposed, as he will inherit if she dies childless. Your agents suspect the Duchess of Ursul is actually more interested in the Duchess of Hellas. That's Bryn. Neither has been linked to a man.
Alright, it's budget time. We're gonna raise taxes. I think it's a cruelty thing. And we're gonna visit the tomb. Alright, we have a new outfit. It's a cat suit. It boosts intrigue. And we're gonna take foreign intelligence classes. And we still are not mood boosted for foreign intelligence, which really hurts me because we're wasting a lot of...
Since their recent revolution, the Tombulans have twice begun gathering troops on the Novan border. Both times, their camps were struck by fierce storms and earthquakes, and they decided to give up on the idea. Pirates are once again operating out of Orcus, although they are currently sticking to the northern seas and no threat to Nova. However, if they turn to slave raids, the Borelians may be quite vulnerable. Agents who have visited Borealis report that all known Lumen shamans seem to have no magical powers at all and perform ritual displays of show and trickery. You are requested to stand in judgment.
If you admit you killed your wife, why do you think I'm going to set you free?
Save me, your majesty. Wasn't my fault. Demons made me do it. I need the priestesses to bless me and make me clean again.
Demons? This man is a lumen. Where did he get a crystal?
It was a demon's magic that killed your wife, not your own magic.
So you know what I am.
He throws out his hands and his fingertips elongate into floating strings of gold.
Die.
Gold chains slash at you like whips. With so much warning, of course, it is easy for you to resist. His attack bounces harmlessly off your shields, the chains flying back in the direction from which they came, where they find an easier target. Before your eyes, the renegade lumen is choked to death by his own powers. After a moment, an orange crystal materializes next to his body.
I guess I'll have to take that for safekeeping.
And we're gonna sneak out. Okay, here we go. Skills. We need more foreign intelligence for the upcoming ending.
Rumor has it that the mother and older sister of the last Duchess of Elath were assassinated 20 years ago by agents from Sedna,
which is why she, as the sole remaining heir, was married off so young. Rumor has it that the Prince of Terax was humiliated by the public dissolution of his betrothal to an heiress after she declared him a coward. The Queen of Sangia is wedded to a non-noble, a court musician whom she initially took as a consort, barring any offspring from inheriting the throne. She has since passed new laws to give not only their children, but also the man himself an equal claim to the throne. Rumor has it that the King of Sangia has become the true power behind the throne, and that he may also have the powers of a lumen. He is a controversial figure within the domain, but ministers who speak against him have been known to disappear. Alrighty. Whew. So we're about a little over halfway through. Let's go talk to Juliana.
If you attack an enemy lumen, and you win, and they leave behind a crystal, is it possible to combine that crystal with mine to make it stronger? Each lumen can hold only one crystal. The only way to combine their magic is if a living wielder chooses to join its power to another.
Oh.
So I should destroy other crystals to stop anyone using them against me. That is the traditional policy, but it is a lie. Lumen crystals cannot be destroyed. Rulers claim otherwise to discourage thieves from seeking dangerous treasures.
What am I supposed to do with a crystal then?
Guard it, or hide it, or give it into other hands to wield. But if the last holder of the crystal was an enemy, the resonance of the crystal will work against you. It will be attuned to a personality as foolish or violent or scheming as the lumen you defeated.
So anyone taking the crystal would probably become a new enemy. That's useless.
A weak-willed candidate might be acceptable to the crystal, and yet still controllable. You could then steer that lumen away from dangerous paths, making an ally and changing the crystal's resonance. It is, however, a dangerous endeavor, and one that requires your complete attention. Not really a project I can work on while I'm so busy studying for my coronation. Well, it's only two crystals. That's not too much trouble. That lore test we failed was, I believe, lore to realize that all the old nobles who had crystals, those crystals must be somewhere too, because they can't be destroyed. All right, week 22. The walkthrough has me doing dogs and horses and falcons, and I'm wondering if that's because there used to be the whole poison chocolate thing. We'll go through it. I'm not going to divert from the walkthrough just yet. You visit the kennels and learn about different breeds of dogs. You learn about dog grooming and the most common diseases and injuries that dogs suffer from. You learn the standard commands for working with trained dogs and retrievers. Oh, I bet it's to open up the hunting, because we do a lot of hunting later. Because hunting adds to cruelty. That's what it is. I regret to inform you that Fabian, the Earl of Titan, and Duke Regent of Elath has passed away. So we have to decide what to do with the child left behind. So for now, we're going to send him to his grandfather. That's what I meant, grandfather. We're going to play with our toys. We're going to do falcons now. Ah, there we are. Animal handling, here we are. Which we're actually at a penalty to right now, which is not good. You are too angry to focus properly on the subject right now. You visit the muse and learn about different kinds of trainable birds, their preferred nesting sites, behavior, and food. There is a woman here to see you. Sabine! The Queen of Sangia was taken in by a musician who turned out to be after her crown. Not only that, but a lumen in disguise and now ruling her domain. I don't sense any magic about this one, though. Musicians are often used as secret agents and messengers. They can be useful and dangerous. So we didn't have enough instrument and voice to realize that she's not as good as she ought to be. And so therefore she's a secret agent, which is frustrating to me because if you know magicians are often used as secret agents and messengers, I shouldn't have to win an instrument voice test to decide that she's not good enough, so she must be a spy? I don't know, that kind of irks me. Some of the choice tests to me feel a little forced. Like, for instance, when they updated the game so that you couldn't leave the taxes as is unless you had accounting. You had to raise or lower them, which to me is like, it just felt like a cheap way to make you have to do that. So this is another one. It's like, it's kind of a cheap test that if you want to hire the musician, you need the foreign internal intelligence enough to know that they're often spies, but then you also need instrument of voice enough to know that she's not good at So what if she was actually really good at both, though? Okay, that's my soapbox. I'm just going to set it over there. We're going to reject her. Thank you, but we were not interested. And they did that with the printing press, too, because in the first version of the game, you could just, okay, sure, we'll take a printing press. I think. No, maybe you still had to train a little bit. But either way, it just feels frustrating that you have to train in things that maybe... I said I'd put my soapbox down, and then I didn't. I lied. Now we have a bonus to animal handling, because we're depressed. So we are going to do horses and falcons. You walk around the stables, meeting the royal horses. You learn about the fragility of hunting birds and the years of training necessary to develop mastery. Luckily, your royal falconer does most of the hard work for you. You learn about the hood and leather jesses, how and when they are worn, and how to keep them maintained and oiled. You receive a letter from young Adair. You also receive an update from your agents. It would seem the Duchess of Lilla is not pleased with your actions and is putting out feelers amongst the other nobles for support. If she means to rebel against you, that is treason. Unfortunately, she's a long way away, in her own power base. Calling her to order may not be easy. The longer you wait, the more dangerous she may become. So we're going to send assassins to kill her. You give orders for assassins to arrange for quiet and natural-looking demise. She is not a young woman, and she just lost her husband. Shouldn't be suspicious. Classes. We are going to take more horses. You learn about caring for your horses, grooming with different brushes, and keeping hooves free of stones. You learn about the different pieces that go into saddles and bridles, how to check for signs of wear, and how to equip and adjust them on a horse. You learn how to mount and dismount a horse, first with a boost and then from the ground. You learn how to handle the reins and guide a horse around the field. And now we may hunt on the weekends. Hunting increases cruelty. So, which is good, because we're trying to get cruel for the ending. So we're going to go hunt. You take out some of your frustrations on helpless prey animals. You now feel somewhat happier and less angry. No judgment or anything. And we actually have a new outfit, which is the animal handling outfit. But we're not going to wear that. We're going to go back to the cat suit. I don't think it matters. Classes, we're going to do composure for royal demeanor and more composure, which we're not at a bonus to. I have unpleasant news to report. Adair, the young lord of Elath, has been assassinated. He was shot with a crossbow while playing on the grounds of his grandfather's estate. Officially an accident, but there were rumors it was for agents from Talais. Then his other daughter married young and died giving birth to Adair. With Adair dead, the only family he has left is his second wife and their son, Connor, who's 15. So we're going to blame the Earl of Ishtar and then execute him. More cruelty. Connor can be Earl of Ishtar. And we don't really want to hand over Elath to Talarist. So right now we're just going to delay. And we're going to play with our toys. Week 27, we're going to do composure and presence. And now we have a bonus. You practice sitting calmly while your teacher circles around you and makes unexpected loud noises. My lady, there are letters for you. There is a birthday celebration coming up. We're not going, so we will send regrets. And we will attend court. We are going to learn elegance and presence. And all my friends are at Gwenel's party. We are going to attend court again. For week 29, we will take elegance and composure. Yes. We're trying to get our composure up because that's necessary for the ending when there's an invasion. You've unlocked a new outfit. The Duke of Lilla has sent you a gift. It's a cushion, finely embroidered with the design of a running horse. It's well done and clearly required hours of needlework, but it's also fairly useless. Or is it? You did, after all, have his mother killed. Does he know? Is this cushion meant to send some sort of message? Or is it somehow trapped? Is it a poisoned pillow? At least it's not enchanted, unless it's enchanted in some way that you can't detect. You place it across the room from you, far away from your bed, so you can keep an eye on it. Tomorrow you'll have it quietly destroyed, but for tonight you won't be sleeping well. Poor thing. We're gonna attend court. Now we're gonna put on our new outfit, which is the coronet. And I'm gonna save again. And we're going to take classes in composure. Your teacher smears your body and clothes with strawberry jam. Alright, stuff is about to start happening. Have you seen Brienne? No, not since I left school. She's gone missing. She's not at school where she should be. I know she was unhappy, but I never expected. She wrote a letter saying she was bored and looking for adventure, but that's all I know. Okay. We are going to attend service again. And we got... That's a lot of yielding to... I like to keep it more even if I can, but... composure and presence is what we're doing now. We should have been able to max that out, but we're depressed. Well, we really ought to stop being depressed, I feel. This says attend court, but I'm not going to do that. We're going to attend services. There. Now we aren't depressed anymore. Week 32. We are going to do 2 presences. And see, now we have a bonus. Unless we needed to be depressed for some reason, I don't think so. You could hold a tournament. What a good idea! We'll offer gold. And then we're going to... The guide says hunting. And I know we need hunting because of the cruelty, but the hunting will make us afraid again, or depressed again, and the depressed wins over the yielding and will be bad for our classes. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to attend service. I hopefully am not making a mistake. So for classes, we're going to do elegance and... The guide has more presence, but we're at presence with this outfit. We're at 100, so we're going to do 2 elegances. I have departed from the guide. That's bad. You are strapped into a corset and hoop skirt and practice walking with these.
And I don't think I need elegance, so I'm not sure why we're doing that and not the other things that we need.
This is the week of the general tournament. Nobles and commoners alike have turned out to compete with each other. So we're not really good at any of these, so the guide says to do falconry. Only nobles take part in the falconry competition, of course. One such is your master of the muse, who catches you trying to sneak down to the competition and gives you an earful about what damage can be done by exhibiting a half-trained bird. So it looks like you won't be taking part in this after all. All the winners are announced and displayed to great cheers, as near queen you place flower garlands around their necks. All of a sudden, a man approaches the winner's platform. It's Kevin, the Earl of Io. In one hand, he carries an armored gauntlet, in the other, a sword. My family's blood is on your hands. Does he know I had his mother, Aris, assassinated? He casts the metal glove to the ground with a clatter and raises his sword, pointing it at you. I challenge you, Elodie, a life for a life. He's challenging you to a duel? Doesn't he know you could burn him to a crisp just by waving your hand? We're gonna kill him with magic. Without a further word, you direct the full force of your magical wrath at the Earl of Io. There is a horrible scream and the smell of burning flesh. I decline. Kevin's sword falls to the ground beside his gauntlet. He won't be needing either anymore. So we're gonna go hunting. Watching prey animals be captured and killed helps put your own problems in perspective. You feel less afraid, but a bit more sad. So our current mood is depressed. I am going to save here because I'm doing something that I never should do during a Let's Play and yet always do. I'm going to depart from my guide. And here's why. Because the next week 34, week 35, and week 36. Week 34, the guide has us studying elegance, which we don't need. Week 35 has us studying elegance and ciphering, and I do not believe ciphering was actually needed for the ending that we got. It was just taking up time. And week 36 was more ciphering, which again, I do not think we needed. So what I'm going to do is... and I have a reason for this. I just don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to study expression. What do I have? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 classes left. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It won't be enough. If we had gone back and done a couple of things slightly different, it would have been enough, but it won't be enough. But that's okay. I don't care. We're going to start with instrument. You tap out chiming dyads on a glockenspiel, and you learn to play notes and scales on a simple wooden recorder. My lady, your father wishes to speak to you. Ships have been sighted on approach from Shangia. Not trade ships, this is a war fleet. Within a week, they will be in Novan waters. Within 2, they will reach the capital. We're not going to recruit any more soldiers. It's too late for that. You will need to draw up a naval strategy. We'll stay in the capital. And we need our mood to stay depressed, which shouldn't be a problem right now. I want to pull down the pressured and the yielding. Or we could hunt for the cruelty. Lonely and willful would help. I'm going to sneak out. Okay. Good, we're still depressed. That was the point. Got 32 instruments, so now we've got a slight bonus because of what we've already learned. I'm going to take 2 voice. You practice deep breathing exercises. You learn the differences in resonance between chest, head, and nose. And now we're going to disastrously lose a naval battle. And we're gonna go hunting. And again, this won't be enough, but we're gonna put it all into decoration. And we're gonna save. And then I'll tell you why we did that in a minute. You discuss the nature of beauty, looking around at landscapes, objects, and people, comparing their aesthetic elements.
Ooh.
Ah. We got to 40. Okay. The invasion of Nova is proceeding. Your coastline is under Shanji control. Soldiers have marched through villages, trampling fields, and frightening citizens. A diplomatic delegation from Shangjia has requested access to the castle to discuss terms, most likely for your surrender. You lack the strength to hold off their armies, and surrendering now will save many lives. It would seem you have no choice. You prepare yourself as best you can to meet the representatives from Shangjia. You expected diplomats and a military representative, a general or an admiral. You did not expect the handsome man decked in jewels who now stands before you, a man announced by your servants as Togami, King of Shangjia. King's consort he should be, if even that much. He's a common musician who married his way onto the throne. And he's a lumen, too. My dear young lady, how difficult this must be. So much responsibility at such a tender age. You yearn to slap the false sympathy off his oily face, but force yourself to remain calm. War benefits no one, don't you think? Such a terrible waste. Better to settle things in a civilized manner. A contest, a game, so to speak, with Nova as the stakes. Should I win, your domain will submit and accept me as overlord with no further resistance. Should I lose, then my armies will leave your domain in peace and shed no more blood. What sort of game? It is well known that Nova is ruled by lumens. As it happens, I too possess the power of a lumen. I propose a formal duel. My power is against yours. The winner takes control of Nova. The loser dies. Your game by your rules from my life. That doesn't sound fair to me. The rules of formal dueling have been passed down for centuries and must be upheld. It is important that we do this by the ancient codes. Why should I? If you refuse, then the war will continue. I'll sweeten the deal. If you meet me in formal Lumen challenge, I'll call off the invasion, even if I win. Really? I swear it by the gods. Nova will be free and safe. Why take that risk? You're winning the war. It's not your land that I want. It's your crystal. It won't work for you. How little you know. Under the right circumstances, resonance can be changed. To gain your power, I am willing to wager my own. Shall we begin? I can sense his power. It's so strong. I've learned everything I possibly could, but he's at least as good as I am. I don't like this, but what choice do I have? He was a musician once, before he married his way into power. Can I use that? Okay, so this is where we make the choice to offer to give him your power. Wait, there's another way. If you want my power, I can give it to you. You don't have to kill me to take my crystal. I'll let you do whatever you want with it. You would willingly submit to my every demand? Yes. Let us see. He points a finger at your father. Join your power to mine, and I will incinerate him. Then I will know that you are mine. So I think we had that choice because of... We did have that choice because of our cruelty that we've been building up. Fine. You close your eyes and will your power into the king of Shangjia, ignoring the horrified screams around you. Then there is a great rush of fire. And so Elodie traded her crown and her father's life for the love of evil. Appointing a shocked minister to rule in her stead, she followed her master Togami back to his homeland. There she was greeted with much suspicion by the hereditary ruler of Shangjia, Togami's wife. Togami sent Elodie to investigate hints of rebellion in the outlying cities of Stangia. There he could watch her performance and test her obedience while avoiding the appearance of impropriety, as long as she was an attractive, unmarried, and morally suspect teenager, she would not be welcome in the queen's presence. Still, Elodie found plenty to entertain herself with. Freed from the expectations of her parents and teachers, she could indulge her every evil whim. As Togami's minion, she was expected to blow people up if they got in her way. As for Nova, they mourned their fallen king and did their best to pretend their black-hearted princess had never existed. The crown passed to Laurent, the Duke of Merva, brother of the old queen. Elodie's name was never to be spoken again. Sad! So that will unlock an achievement called To Serve Evil, because we're serving evil. Now I'm going to go back really quickly and I think fail at something, but let us see. So at this point, we can refuse to give him our powers and accept his terms for a duel. You trade attacks, one spell sensed and countered by another, reserving your strength as much as possible. It might almost be exciting if your life weren't on the line. You need to end this quickly, before his experience allows him to come up with a trick you can't defeat. He's used to dealing with magical attacks, but he might not be expecting a physical one. Perhaps if you rushed him, you could take him off guard. Up close, he couldn't use his fancy spells. But what would you do then? You still have to use magic to win. You can't just grab him and bang his head against the floor. Perhaps you could focus your power into the shape of a sword and attack him with that. Or if you could distract him somehow, you could cast a spell he couldn't block. So we don't have anywhere near the skills for magic sword because we did, like, no reflexes and no swording at all. But dazzling takes decoration skills, and I think it takes 40, so let's check. Nope, we failed. So let me check something real quick. Doot, 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 doot. Please wait. Continue to wait. Oh, dazzling him takes decoration of 70. So if we had had decoration of 70, we could have killed him. And we died. Everything goes dark. There's a little death. Ah, look at poor little dead Elodie. Hold on. Load game, go back to here. Skills. Theoretically, I think we could go back and siphon off the elegance and presence. I don't actually know why we did those, because you need composure not to smack Togami, but you don't actually need elegance or presence for any of this following conversation. So I actually think that if we'd gone back, how many weeks was that? It was quite a few, actually. Please wait. We started at week 26, the elegance and presence stuff. So let's go to provinces and let's say skip button. Oops, not what I wanted to do. 21. No, don't overwrite. Load. Load is what I want. Yes, load the 21. Walkthroughs are so nice. So at week 21, or week 22. This is, I guess, the upcoming week, and the save shows you what week you are on. So at this point, we were still doing animal handling, so we did two dogs. And I'm gonna fly through this real fast. Skip ahead.
We did send to his grandfather, and then we did play with toys. Then we did falcons, which we also did not need. Oh, but we needed for the to unlock the horses and the hunting. Reject her, skip ahead, attend service. Now we're doing horses and falcons. Send assassins to kill her. Visit the tomb. Now we're gonna do two sets of horses. Skip ahead. Hunting. Now we're going to do composure and more composure. Wait a second. Yeah, okay. We will blame the Earl of Ishtar. We will execute him. We will delay. We will play with toys. We are currently yielding, which is a bonus to royal demeanor, which is good. We're going to do two elegances. Actually, we want an elegance and a presence, and then another elegance and presence, and then composure to max out. Boom. There are letters for you. Skip ahead. Send your regrets. And then we attended court to keep ourselves pretty yielding. How is our mood? We need to stay yielding. We don't want to get depressed or pressured. No pressure. It's fine because it's past yielding. Classes. We're going to do elegance and presence again so we can unlock the 25. Boom. All my friends are at Gwynnell's party. She wasn't happy. We've got a mood of... And eventually we want to get depressed. So I want to pull yielding... Is there a single willful? There is a single willful. Excellent. That's what I want. We're still yielding, which is what we want. And we're going to take two composure classes. And that will open a new outfit. Excellent. Skip ahead. What's our mood? We just got an afraid. Okay. Is there like a lonely... So lonely and cheerful. I don't want to be cheerful. There's a lonely and afraid. I don't want that either. There's a... Bloody heck. Minus two afraid and a depressed, but that'll ruin my yielding. There's a... Willful, but that will ruin my yielding bonus. Okay, we can't sneak out. We can't... We could play with toys. I don't like that option. We can't... Walk in the garden. We can walk in the gardens. That's probably the best one. I don't want to visit the treasury. I don't want to attend court. I don't want to explore the castle... Actually, I do. That's fine. We'll do the lonely and afraid. Hard game, y'all. I keep saying that, but I mean... Okay, so we're going to put on our new coronet for royal demeanor. Skills. Classes. We need to max out composure for Togami. So let's do that. 100. There it is. Heck yeah. Okay, no decisions now. And now what I want to do is I want to be depressed. The best, easiest way to do that is to pull the willful down one. And I'm going to save here because wouldn't it just be so awkward if evil Elodie 6. If I made a screw up at this point. So at this point, we're depressed and we're going to start dumping it into expression decoration stuff. So one of the tricks that we do here is we already know the trick that you need to get each of these up to 25 before you can get past 50, because we care about getting decoration up to 70, as you recall. As you train in this, you get a little tiny bonus that's equal to the amount that you've already trained. So we did the 30 in dance, so there's a plus 0.3 to doing dance. So in order to get decoration higher and maximize that bonus, I'm going to do voice first, then instrument, and then that small amount will give us a little bit of a bonus here, and we might get to 70 in time. How cool would that be? So we're going to say expression. We're going to do two voices. Well, actually, I'm going to start with instrument, because that's the one I care about the least, to be honest. All right, 31 points in that. Now we're going to... we want to stay depressed. I would like to pull down some of the other things. It would be nice to do a lonely afraid. I don't need to keep hunting because, well, I guess it would be nice to keep our cruelty up. I've never had a cruelty ending. Alright, where's our mood? There's our mood. Now we're gonna do voice. We're gonna say gold. Mood. Hunting has no effect, which I kind of want no effect, so that works for me. And we are going to take classes in decoration now. So if we look at this, we've got a plus one because of the current mood depressed giving a bonus to expression. But we also have a plus 0.67 that we have because of this right here. So that's how you can potentially eke out a few more points. We'll see. Nice. Doing well. New outfit, but we're not going to put it on. Are we? Skip ahead. We're going to say falconry. Depressed, pressured. Kill him with magic. Nice. Mood is still depressed, but I guess we'll hunt? And skills. Alright, heck yeah, we should get to decoration. So what happens, by the way, if we go to Toga? We still have a role, demeanor, a composure of 100. So I'm going to leave on the Toga for the extra bonuses to bloody hell, I can't talk. Expression. I'm going to save again. I like the Toga outfit best. Probably because it honestly looks like the most comfortable thing she owns. That magic girl one is just silly beyond belief. Your father wishes to speak to you. We're going to say don't recruit soldiers. Stay in the capital. Our mood is currently still depressed, not surprisingly. We're going to hunt some more. Mood, skills. Alright, so I'm going to do one decoration. Wow, weird. That's We could probably even sing to him if we really wanted to. Because I checked the wiki just now, and the sing to him is a test of instrument of voice, and you have to get over 100. But it's instrument of voice together. So I'm pretty sure we have that at this point. Oh, what am I doing? Yeah, so I mean, we could even do the angel ending despite being the cruelest person to ever live. It's cruel to be kind. So I'm just gonna beef that up for the heck of it, honestly. So here's the Sanji invasion. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Foreign intelligence success, Lumen success, composure success. Alright. Here they're gonna try to do this. We could sing to him, but I'm not gonna sing to him. I like that ending best, though, I'm gonna be honest. We're gonna accept his terms. Then I must. Alright, let's do all this. We did a resist magic. We did a sense magic. What are our options here? We can either make a sword or we can dazzle him. So let's go and dazzle him. Drawing on your knowledge of design and your control over light, you surround yourself with strands of rainbow color which flow over and around your image. But that's only the beginning. Once you are in the cover of this prismatic shield, you can create a false image of yourself and step invisibly aside. The strain of keeping up the illusion of yourself responding to Togami's attacks is high. You can't keep this up for long. You have to end it now. Stepping up as close behind him as you dare to limit the time and space he has to react, you raise your hand and force out a high-speed disc of solid light. It drives into his neck, killing him instantly. You have won. Hey, look at that! we're kind of badass around here. Just gonna say. So, wow, that's awesome. Let's stop being depressed. That would be nice. What would be great? Cheerful and willful would be super great. Is that an option? There's cheerful and angry. There's willful and lonely. Not a lot of cheerfuls. So let's bring up the cheerful and angry. You sneak down to the castle dungeons and amuse yourself by poking the locked up peasants with sticks. Poor fools. I've never seen that before. I'm sorry. I just cracked up. Poor fools. So hey, we can like do pretty much whatever we want now to get to the ending. Okay. What do we want to do? I'll tell you what I know I want to do, but I don't think we can because our mood's all mucked up, is I'd like to boost our lore because we don't know any lore. But I'm checking what that mood is. Yielding, afraid, and pressured. Wow. So, like, none of that. Oh, well, we could get pressured up. Bum, 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 bum. Classes, let's take some lore. Just for the heck of it.
Only a lumen can channel magic, and only with the help of a tuned crystal. The ability to control a crystal seems to be inherited, so crystals can be passed from parent to child upon the lumen's death. The kings and queens of Noma have all been lumens for centuries, but in modern times, magic is only used for ceremonial occasions and in the direst of emergencies. Once you defeated the King of Sanji in a duel, the invasion was meant to be over. In practice, it is not quite so easy to expel a foreign army from your lands, particularly when their leadership is falling apart. The remaining Sanji in general seem surprisingly eager to go home and left without a fuss, but a large number of soldiers have broken ranks and run amok, looting and pillaging their way through Nova just for fun. A number of royal holdings have been damaged and valuables stolen. Not only do you lose them, but you will have to pay for repairs. With so many renegades on the loose, Nova seems likely to have severe bandit problems for years to come. When Togami died, he left behind a crystal, a mauve lumen crystal, with glimmers of pink where it catches the light. Such a pretty bauble from such an ugly event. Since Nova won the duel, this crystal is now your rightful prize, but you have no idea what to do with it. And there's no visit Juliana option. So what did we want? I wanted pressure to go up. And the only way to do that is to attend court, which will do other things to my mood. It'll make me depressed, for one. Why is the wiki broken? I already have pressured at 3. And I have depressed at 4. So I would need 2 cheerful to bring that down enough that... Oh, we can go hunting again. So if I can get depressed down one more, I'll be pressured. But we're practically at the end, so I don't know that it matters. Divination and lore. I didn't mean to do that. Can I change it? No, of course I can't.
There's something going on that no one wants to tell you about. Servants avoid your eyes and scurry away. Ministers converse in low, worried tones. Yet as far as you can tell, your territory is secure. No more attacks are underway, so what could be wrong? You lie awake in bed at night, worrying that perhaps all of your choices have been wrong ones. Time has slipped by so quickly. Only 2 weeks remain before your birthday celebration. All right.
Let's do an extravagant feast. And let's bring our depression down. Okay, good. We feel pressured. Not that it matters. We'd want 2 meditations at this point. I was gonna try to get lore up real high just to see what happened, but...
You were happy to collaborate with the designers to ensure you were shown off to the best possible effect. Whomever you decide to marry will be elevated to the highest ranks. There is the little matter of Adair's assassination. Someone from Talaise would be the most likely culprit, especially someone from Sedna like Talarist. He had the most to gain. The old Duckle family of Elath suffered a number of unfortunate accidents over the past 20 years. Most were too long ago for Talarist to have any possible involvement. Still, you are not above ordering assassinations yourself, but that doesn't necessarily make it a desirable trait in a husband.
For right now, we'll say we won't marry anyone. You were in too hurry to get married. You have a country to run. So
So we did one divination and then another lore. Okay.
I just wanted to get that up because I thought, hey, maybe it'll be useful, but it wasn't.
All right. We take the oath, and now we are queen.
What kind of ending did we get? Probably not a great one.
Over time, Elodie and Charlotte slowly mended their relationship. Charlotte could never quite accept that either her mother or her beloved cousin had intended to kill the other. Eventually, she chose to cast the entire matter as a tragic accident and refused to speak any more about it. Following Elodie's victory over the Shangjian king, the public opinion of Lumens rose to a height that hadn't been seen in 100 years. I've never gotten this one before. Young children would dress up and play at being magical kings and queens. Freed from the need for secrecy, the Duchess Juliana and the Priestess Selene were able to announce their shared magical powers and their love. At Elodie's prompting, the lovers pledged their devotion to each other in a private ceremony, after which Selene retired from the priesthood to accompany her wife to Ursul. Oh, I'm crying. That's sweet. I've never gotten that one before. Y'all have always asked for the good Lumen ending. I guess the good Lumen ending is from defeating Togami with magic, so there you go. After the failed invasion, relations with Sanjia remained tense. First came the recriminations and demands from the Queen of Sanjia, devastated by the death of her husband, which Elodie ignored because fuck that. Sorry. Next came the subtler approaches, the quiet gratitude, and offers for alliances from ministers who were thrilled to see Togami gone. Elodie ignored those also, which was just as well, since the next thing to arrive was the preserved head of one of those traitorous ministers sent by the Queen of Shangji as a warning. There was no sign of war in the immediate future, but there was not likely to be an alliance either. The matter of the rulership of Elath had to be dealt with. After so many troubles, the last thing Elodie wanted was armed conflict between Nova and Talaes. Still, while Talaris, the Duke of Sedna, was the nearest blood heir, he was a foreigner, and the rulership of Elath had been tenuous for far too long already. To solve the problem, Elodie found a compromise. A promising native administrator would be raised to the Duchess of Elath, and then married to the Duke of Sedna. Their wedding would strengthen ties across the border without weakening either position. Nice! Well done, us! Elodie appeared disinclined to marry, instead enjoying herself with a stable of favorites, then discarding them as soon as they bored her. Since one of these affairs did produce the all-important crown prince, the rest of Nova had no complaint. After all, she was the queen. She could do whatever and whoever she wanted. Perfect. Love it. The invention of the printing press sparked the beginning of a new age of literacy and knowledge. No longer were books for the sole preserve of noble and wealthy. Now information and ideas could be easily passed from one place to another. As the birthplace of this invention, Nova was at the center of a storm of change. Elodie loved the feeling of power at her fingertips. She studied the legends of Lumens of the past, in particular their weapons and their wars. Just how had the old queens summoned immortal shadows and bound them to their will? And could she do it again? The people of Nova learned to fear their queen, who ruled with a wicked whimsy. Anyone who dared to displease her might be whipped, or beheaded, or worse, set free to spend the next month in a panic waiting for the sword to fall. Her rise to power had shaped Elodie into a cruel woman who took pleasure in the suffering of others, and thus Queen Elodie's legacy stretched into the future. So, well done, us. That is not the only evil Elodie queen ending. I know there's a version where you can, there's a version where you can sacrifice your cousin Charlotte as a sacrifice to the Kraken. And I think there's also a version that implies like a like a BDSM relationship between Elodie and Alice the Maid. I haven't seen it. I've just heard people talking about it. I will look into it. I know there's several more achievements that I don't have and haven't got and so on and so forth. But that's one more achievement to serve evil, and then also you got to see us have a good ending for the Lumens and for Juliana and her wife to get married, which is very sweet. So once again, this has been Long Live the Queen. I'm looking at the achievements real quick. We we still haven't romanced a commoner. We still haven't faced a commoner uprising. I still haven't ordered a human sacrifice. I still haven't had a rebellion in Merva. I still haven't caused an earthquake. I haven't poisoned a defenseless chicken. I don't know that one. And I haven't imprisoned my uncle for acts against the crown. So, we definitely still have more to do. I will probably continue to be looking up walkthroughs and finding ways to get there through other players, because some of those are kind of obscure. If you have a change log, like a game log that you want to send to me that does one or more of those merits or gives the ending that you want to see, I know a lot of people have been interested in evil Elodie and Alice being her lover and such. If you have that and want to send it to me, you can email me at, it's my name, it's annamardal@gmail.com, and tell me what name you want to give credit, and I will try to make a video. Because otherwise I have to figure it out by myself, and that's hard. So thank you for sticking with me. I know this was a 2-hour long video. I think that's kind of the standard length for a Long Live the Queen walkthrough, at least when I'm talking. And I really appreciate just all of you so much. I don't really even know why I have so many subscribers, because I don't understand why anyone would want to listen to me talk. But you do, and it cheers me up really a whole lot. So thank you, because that's super awesome. And if you're not a subscriber and you want to be, there's a button. So feel free to subscribe. You get little email updates whenever I post videos. Thank you so much. And you guys have just the best of possible days. Bye-bye.